Welcome to this episode of Ask the Guitar Coach, the only podcast where you get answers to all your guitar-related questions. If you're interested in developing your guitar skills and reaching your music goals, please send me an email at the email address ioannis@ioannis.org. That is ioannis@ioannis.org. So that I can let you know about all the different packages of Elite Guitar Coaching and how you can get private coaching by me. Without further ado, let's go to our question for the day. Is weight training going to help me in any way with my guitar playing? So here is a really interesting question. This viewer asks whether training with weights, we're not talking about weightlifting, but just training with weights, is going to help him in any way with his guitar playing. And why do I say it's an interesting question is because it's very often that I find guitar players being interested in weightlifting, weight training and bodybuilding. There are some similarities. There are things that are both based on a progressive involvement and, you know, progressive resistance, like in guitar, you start with a slow speed and you slowly build up using a metronome. In weightlifting, you start with low weights and then you slowly, over a large period of time, a very long period, ramp up the weights. And there are some similarities to this process. So it is something that I've seen several guitar players wonder about. Is it going to help them? Is it going to stop them from becoming a good player? So the answer is a resounding yes, it is going to help you. And the very first way it's going to help you is by emotionally regulating your life in general. Let me explain. When you're training with weights, your body releases endorphins afterwards. Endorphins have a calming and a pain-numbing effect, very similar to low dosages of morphine. So actually, endorphins and morphine, they bind the same receptor in the human brain. So they're very close to their effect. What this means is that you become more calm, but without taking actual drugs. You become more, there is less emotional up and down. So basically it regulates emotionally your life and your behavior. And this is always good because you become less emotionally reactive, which means you can follow your plan of practice without worrying too much about what's going on, without stressing too much. So this is a really, really good thing. Runners, people who run, and we also get a lot of endorphins from running, they always talk about this runner's high, which is basically the rapid release of endorphins in the bloodstream. The second reason, which was always more important for me, it's that training with weights actually minimizes my chances of injury while playing guitar. Why is that? Because my muscles, my ligaments, my tendons, they become, even the cartilage, they become much more resilient, which means I have much more leeway to do some more crazy stuff on the guitar that could kind of hurt someone who was not trained, and now I can get away with it. Now, when I was younger, it was a little bit more difficult to get hurt playing the guitar. I really had to overdo it, but getting older, your body is not exactly the same way as it used to be, so it takes longer to bounce back from getting hurt from anything, and so it's a good idea to have this like extra buffer of being safe from injury. So one way that training weight is going to help you a lot is by helping you avoid guitar related injuries. Now, this doesn't mean that you can go totally crazy just because you're lifting some weights, but you will have an extra protective buffer. The next reason training with weights is going to help you is because you will learn how to be consistent and better disciplined. So one of the main things that training with weights is gonna instill in you is that being consistent about training is the most important thing. It's more important than lifting like bigger weights or anything like that. So this is something that's it's going to become a mindset that several guitar players are in dire need of, because the way we are kind of brought up by reading websites and reading guitar magazines, it's a, oh, whenever I have the mood, I'm in the mood, I will pick up the guitar and play a little bit whenever the inspiration strikes me. So it's all very like emotionally reactive. Like if I'm in the mood, I will just play for a little bit. While this is really not the case, if you want to get better at guitar, you have to play it religiously every day for a few hours. And training with weights is going to help you get this mindset much more in order. So even though training with weights is a very physical thing, it also helps a lot with your mindset. So going on to the final reason that I found that training with weights is going to help you is with your health in general. People who train, who work out, especially if you work out with weights and you use progressive resistance, you will be in better health in several areas of your, in several parts of your body. So your strength is going to be better. You're just going to generally be more healthy. Let's not go into more detail. Now, if you're more healthy, that means you're going to have less health problems and you're going to be more more productive and more in tune with whatever you're doing. You will have more willpower, and as a result of these things, you will have more productivity because you're going to be rested for more hours, you're going to have more stamina, and this helps in every area of your life and in any area of your life that you're concentrating on. So if you have taken guitar seriously and you're going to with a champion mentality that you're going to be practicing for hours per day for a few years to become really, really high level and see how far you can take it, it's really going to help you to have this maximum health level, because you can use all this health and all this willpower and this productivity to fuel your guitar practicing. So there you have it. Quite a few reasons why training with weight is going to help your guitar playing. I hope this video was helpful, and I will see you on the next episode of Ask the Guitar Coach. Until then, keep sending me your questions and I'll do my best to answer them in a future episode. Bye bye.